Hello! Today I will be going through how to connect a 1280 to an iQUBE2 using a 3-wire RS-422 connection. Prior to this video, I defaulted all 4 of my iQUBE2 boards, then went through the manual board assignment process, and finally, I set the dip switches on my iQUBE2 so it would work with half-duplex RS-422 communication. Here is how I have my connectors wired. The black connector will go to a serial port on the 1280, while the green connector goes to port J7 on the iQUBE. I have chosen RS-422 for my communication medium because of the distance I can achieve between the iQUBE and the 1280. The distance we can achieve with RS-422 is approximately 1,000 feet, compared to the suggested 10 feet that we could get with RS-232 when using 115/200 baud rate. To begin, we will enter configuration. Once in the configuration menu, we will proceed to the communications menu. My iQUBE is connected to port 1, so I will leave the serial menu selected as well as port 1. I will select the option Input Type and switch it from Command Processor to iQUBE2 and then press Done. Before we enter the iQUBE2 for configuration, we will change the port type from RS-232 to RS-422. Since I am using 3-wire communication, I will leave the duplex option set to half. After changing the port type to iQUBE2, I also receive an additional menu titled iQUBE2. I will press this new option, and when it asks me to enter iQUBE2 setup mode, I will select Yes. Now that I am in the iQUBE2's configuration, I want to make sure I am properly wired between my indicator and my iQUBE. So I will press the Test iQUBE2 Connection option. I will now press OK to test the connection. As you can see here, my test was successful and returned the serial number of my primary board. If this test is unsuccessful, you will need to verify the settings in your indicator as well as your wiring, and depending upon your communication medium, you will need to check the iQUBE's dip switches as well. Since I have verified that my iQUBE2 is talking to my indicator, I will press the OK button, and since I manually assign my boards on the iQUBE, I will select Get From Device to upload my assigned boards from my iQUBE to my indicator. After pressing Yes and receiving my iQUBE's configuration, I will go to Base. Here, I can see the serial numbers of the other 3 boards that are a part of my iQUBE system. Make sure you have 1 serial number here for all boards that are in addition to your primary. So if you have 4 boards, you should see 3 numbers here. And if you only have 1 board, you should see no numbers here. I want to remove the warm-up period for my iQUBE so that I can use it right away. So I will select the General tab. I will set my warm-up delay from 6 to 0. The warm-up time is a period of minutes where the iQUBE2 would be inaccessible. So in the instance we just changed, it would have gone 6 minutes before we could use it. We will proceed to the tab titled Load Cells next. I am emulating a truck scale, so I will leave my cell's capacity at 75,000, but if your cells have a different capacity, you can change it here, and then select Apply to All if it is appropriate for your setup. I will proceed to the Load Cell Assignment tab next. You can have up to 4 individual scales in an iQUBE2, with an option for a total scale as well. I only have 1 scale, so I will leave scale number 1 selected. I am going to assign an additional 8 cells to my scale for a total of 12. I will click the Assign button for load cells 5 through 12. I will now exit the base menu and go into the Scales menu. Since I assigned all of my cells to scale 1, I want to make sure scale number 1 is selected. Since I am setting the scale up to be a 120,000 pound truck scale, counting by 20 pounds, I will need to verify several things. The first thing to verify is the graduations. I want to make sure that the grads are set to 6,000. Next, I will proceed to the Formatting tab. I want a fixed zero, also known as a dummy zero, for my decimal position, and I want my display divisions set to 2. Now that all of my settings have been set, I will return to the main menu for the iQUBE2, and I will select the Send to Device option and select Configuration, since I have not calibrated the scale at this point. Once the configuration has been sent to the iQUBE, I will go back to 1280 setup. We have set up the iQUBE2, but we still need to assign the iQUBE to a scale. So I will proceed to the Scales tab in the 1280's menu. I will leave Scale 1 selected and then press the Edit button. I will go down to iQUBE2 Scale and select it, and then I will select Connection Port 1, Scale 1. Once the checkmark is next to your selected scale, you can press the Done button. And once you are returned to the Scale Kind selection, press Done again to confirm your assignment of the iQUBE to the scale. I will now proceed to save and exit. I did not calibrate my scale yet, so we can see a number on the screen, but at this point it doesn't really correspond with anything. You will need to calibrate the iQUBE2 before using. This has been a demonstration of how to set up the iQUBE2 with the 1280. Thank you for your time.